If you collaborate with others on federal grant applications, you're going to want to familiarize yourself with Grants.gov's user roles and access levels. Doing so can help your team create a streamlined workflow. Let's start by looking at user roles, the foundation of a user's Grants.gov profile. When users register with Grants.gov, they can be assigned the Manage Workspace role, the Authorized Organization Representative, or AOR role, or no role at all. The Manage Workspace role enables a user to create new workspaces and serve as the workspace owner. The Authorized Organization Representative role enables a workspace participant to submit applications on behalf of the organization. Users with no role are limited within Workspace to filling out application forms. Within a workspace, though, users may take on additional responsibilities. A workspace participant is any Grants.gov user who has been added to a workspace. At minimum, participants are able to complete and edit forms. Participants with an AOR user role are able to submit their workspace application when it is complete. Workspace owners, meanwhile, are participants with either the Manage Workspace role or the AOR role who have been given ownership of a workspace. This ownership can be transferred, and it gives the user the ability to add or remove participants from both inside and outside the applicant organization. Some teams will have at least one super user. These are AORs who have been given additional access to act as the applicant organization's eBiz point of contact. The eBiz point of contact is an admin user with access to SAM who administers user roles. Super users can either be an AOR with expanded access or an AOR with the organization's MPIN. For more on these super user roles, consult the online user guide. On Grants.gov at this URL, we have created a chart that maps every key workspace action to the required roles or access levels. For example, when completing forms, all three participant types can contribute, as well as super users outside the workspace. But when submitting, a participant must have the AOR role, or a super user from outside the workspace must click Submit. Roles and access levels are explained in more detail in the online user guide and under the Applicants tab on Grants.gov.